हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून। द एक्सपेरिमेंट वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म ऑनलाइन टुडे इज स्टडी ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टराइज्ड रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाई। द सर्किट डायग्राम नीडेड टू परफॉर्म एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ ट्रांजिस्टराइज्ड रेगुलेटेड पावर सप्लाई is displayed here. You can see this circuit diagram in the video. Let me explain the circuit diagram. This is the input AC voltage from AC mains. This input AC voltage from AC mains is connected to primary of a transformer. The secondary of a transformer has three terminals: this terminal, this terminal, and this terminal. The middle terminal is known as center tap, and therefore this transformer is known as center tapped step down transformer. As it is step down transformer, voltage at the secondary of this transformer is much smaller than voltage at the primary. The transformer we used here is 606 transformer. Meaning of 606 transformer is when we provide about 220 to 240 volt to the primary of the transformer, the voltage coming at the secondary is 606. That is, voltage at the center tap is 0, voltage here is 6, voltage here is 6, and therefore this transformer is 606 center tapped step down transformer. As you know, the input is AC voltage, and to convert the AC voltage to DC voltage we use rectifier. This diode and this diode, these two together form the full wave rectifier. This upper diode takes care of positive half cycle of every input AC voltage. The lower diode takes care of the negative half cycle of every cycle of input AC voltage. It means that positive half cycles are rectified by the upper diode, negative half cycles are rectified by the lower diode. As you see here, cathodes of these two diodes are made common and connected at the positive terminal of electrolytic capacitor of value 10,000 ohm. This capacitor works as input is input capacitor filter. This input capacitor filter is used for separation of AC and DC. Why there is need of separation of AC and DC? The voltage coming at the common cathode in positive cycle as well as in negative cycle is unidirectional or pulsating DC voltage. Meaning of pulsating DC voltage, it is mixture of AC voltage and DC voltage. Whenever we talk of a regulated power supply or a power supply, output of the power supply is always DC voltage. We don't want any impurity AC in the DC voltage, and therefore we use the capacitor here. Property of the capacitor is to allow AC voltage to pass through it and to block the DC voltage. So the pulsating or impure DC voltage coming here, AC components from this pulsating or impure DC will be passed through this capacitor to the ground. Ground is not shown here. Actually, this whole lower line is ground line. Okay, and what left here after AC is passed to the ground through the capacitor, pure DC is left. This pure DC is coming here. Now, here the Zener diode, which is used as voltage regulator, and here we have a transistor, power transistor. Emitter of power transistor is connected at the output of the rectifier, at the output of the capacitor filter, collector. The emitter of this transistor is connected at the output side, and base of the transistor is connected to cathode of the Zener diode. This resistance is acting as biasing resistance. Now let us see what is use of this biasing resistance and the transistor in this circuit. When the DC voltage comes across parallel of this capacitor, this will be positive, this will be negative. This is true for rectification of positive up cycle as well as negative up cycle. Then current starts flowing through this resistance 68 ohm, because the transistor, power transistor 2N3055 is now cut off. It is not in working. When it is not in working, current passes through this 68 ohm resistance. Okay, the voltage across Zener diode is now smaller than its breakdown voltage. As voltage across Zener diode is smaller than its breakdown voltage, it is not conducting. It means that this Zener diode is acting as high resistance, this transistor is also acting as high resistance, and therefore the current carried by 68 ohm resistance here will get accumulated as voltage. As soon as the voltage accumulated here becomes more than breakdown voltage of the Zener diode, breakdown of Zener diode takes place, it starts conducting heavily. So the heavy current of Zener diode will be flowing as base current of this transistor. This transistor comes in working and output is made available here at the parallel, across the resistance box. Parallel to the resistance box in the voltmeter, we can measure the output DC voltage. This is the milliammeter connected across emitter of the transistor to measure the load current or output current. As I told, emitter is connected to the output, collector is connected to the output of the rectifier, to the output of the filter. Emitter is connected at the output of our power supply. Base is connected to the cathode of this Zener diode. Now, what is purpose of using this transistor here? This transistor is a power transistor, and when base current of a transistor is large, the transistor is brought into saturation. Whenever a transistor is brought into saturation, its output current remains constant. Actually, its collector current remains constant whenever a transistor is brought into saturation. Collector current of a transistor is approximately equal to emitter current. As this transistor is driven into saturation, its collector current will be constant, fairly constant, and therefore its load current, that is emitter current. Emitter current of this transistor is nothing but the load current, and therefore load current of this power supply will become constant. If we don't use the transistor here, what will happen? B, current flowing through the zener diode may change slightly because of changes in temperature. Now, why does temperature of the zener change? When the zener is working, current flow through it, it has a certain resistance. Whenever a current is flowing through a resistance, heat is developed that will produce high temperature. That is, the temperature of the zener will change as it is conducting in breakdown region. That may carry current flowing through the zener diode, and if transistor is not used, zener current will be the load current. That is, load current will change automatically because of changes in temperature, because of variations in temperature. And we don't want to have any variations in temperature. We know that collector current of a transistor is beta times its base current. For general transistors, this beta may range from 300 to 500. It means that the emitter current coming here, which is taken as approximately equal to the collector current, is about 500 times more than the base current or than the zener current. It means that the transistor is working in saturation, and when the transistor is working in saturation, the collector current will be constant, that will maintain emitter current fairly constant. So the variations in the resistance, the variations in the impedance of the zener diode with the temperature will be suppressed by this transistor when it is allowed to work in the saturation, which maintains fairly constant load current. Okay, so to suppress changes in the zener diode due to variations in temperature, we use this power transistor here. Okay, this is series voltage regulator. This type of structure, this type of construction is known as series voltage regulator. Because of this series voltage regulator, the output current as well as output voltage of this regulated power supply will be held fairly constant, and therefore this type of voltage regulator is always advantageous over other voltage regulators. We call this regulator as transistorized regulated power supply. This type of voltage regulator is called as transistorized regulated power supply. This is because the power transistor 2N3055 helps the zener diode and to the whole circuit to maintain load current constant along with constant output voltage. This is the circuit diagram needed to study experimentally line regulation and load regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. We need this circuit diagram to study experimentally line and load regulation of transistorized power supply. Have a look carefully at this circuit diagram, because this circuit diagram is constructed here, and now I am going to tell you how the connections are made for this circuit diagram. Because you need to remember this circuit diagram in the examination, you are required to draw this circuit diagram. Okay, then you have to get it checked by the examiner. After that, you need to construct the circuit. Construction of the circuit will also be checked by the examiner, and after that you can go for performing the experiment. So with the help of this circuit diagram, let me tell you how the connections are made, how the circuit is built, and the circuit is here. This is the demostat or auto transformer used to provide voltage from AC mains to the primary of this center tapped step down transformer. 1, 2, 3, these are the three terminals. Center one is center tapped terminal, upper terminal, lower terminal. This will form the three terminal secondary of the transformer. This is upper diode rectifying all positive half cycles of AC input voltage. This is lower diode rectifying all negative half cycles of the AC voltage. The cathodes of these two are made common and it is then given to this capacitor of 1000 microfarad, which is working as the filter which bypasses the AC component present in this impure DC to the ground, and it blocks DC here. This DC, as I told, will allow this circuit work together. As and when voltage coming at the cathode of the zener diode brought by this 68 ohm resistance becomes more than breakdown voltage of the zener diode, and the circuit will start working. This is the millimeter used to measure the load current. This is the resistance box used as variable load resistance. This is the voltmeter used to measure the output voltage of this regulated power supply. This is in short about the construction of the circuit made for study of transistorized regulated power supply. As I told, in this experiment we are going to study this experiment in two different parts: line regulation and load regulation. In line regulation, we are going to vary the input AC voltage in regular steps from 0 to 220 volt, and at each value of this input voltage, we shall measure the load current and load voltage. At this time, the value of load resistance is held constant. Let me keep this value of RL constant at 3000 ohm. So when I go for study of line regulation of transistorized regulated power supply, I will hold RL is equal to 3000 ohm constant. So on the top of the table for line regulation, right there load is equal to 3000 ohm constant. Okay, then now you can have a look at this dimmer. You will find that this is zero. When AC input provided to this power supply is zero, the current is zero and the output voltage is zero. When input AC voltage is zero, the output voltage is zero. In this part, we are not going to measure the current. In the output part, in the load regulation, we may write the current as well as the voltage. Okay. Now, let me change the input AC voltage to 20 volt. AC is made now 20 volt, and you will find that the DC current is still zero. Okay. Then let us have AC input is equal to 40 volt, and if you look here, you will find that the output DC voltage is still zero. Let me go to 60 volt. When we go to 60 volt, still the output voltage is zero. Let me go to 80 volt. Is it working? Hello. The output voltmeter was not working properly, and therefore we were getting zero for all input voltages. Now we have replaced this voltmeter. Let us start the reading. For zero input voltage, output voltage is zero. It is correct. Now let me go for input is equal to 20 volt. AC input is made 20 volt, and now you will find here output AC, output DC voltage is 0.2 volt. Output DC voltage is 0.2 volt. Let us change the input AC voltage to 40 volt. When input AC voltage is 40 volt, output DC voltage is 0.5 volt. Then let us go for input AC voltage is equal to 60 volt, which gives output DC voltage is equal to 0.8 volt. After that, let us have input AC voltage is equal to 80 volt, where the corresponding DC output voltage is 1.4 volt. Then let us take input AC voltage is equal to 100 volt and the output DC voltage is 2 volt. Now the input AC voltage is made 120 volt. Output DC voltage is, it is about 2.6 volt. Sorry, it is about 2.6 volt. Now let me go for input voltage is equal to 140 volt. Corresponding output voltage is 3.2 volt. Okay, then let us make AC input voltage 160 volt, which gives the output voltage is equal to 3.2 volt. Then input AC voltage 180 volt, output is still 3.2. Input AC voltage is made 200 volt, output is still 3.2. The input AC voltage is made 220 volt and the output is still 3.2 volt. Okay, so this is about the readings for study of line regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. Here you will find that the load is held constant at 3000 ohm. Input voltage taken in this column. Corresponding output DC voltage is taken in this column. When input is 0 AC, output is 0 DC. Input 20 AC, output 0.2 volt DC. Input 40 volt AC, output 0.5 volt DC. Input 60 volt AC, output 0.8 volt DC. Input 80 volt AC, output 1.4 volt DC. Input 100 volt AC, output 2 volt DC. Input 120 AC, output 2.6 DC. Input 140 volt AC, output 3.2 DC. Input 160 volt, 180 volt, 200 volt, 220 volt. For all these values of input voltages, the output voltage remains constant at 3.2 volt DC voltage. This is about the observation table to study line regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. Before going to the second part, let me tell you how to plot graph for this part. As you know, there are three parameters: the input voltage, the output voltage, and the load resistance. Load resistance is held constant. The independent variable is input voltage. Independent variable input voltage is taken on x-axis. Output DC voltage is a dependent variable. This dependent variable output DC voltage is taken on y-axis. Now take proper scale on x-axis for input AC voltage and proper scale on y-axis for output DC voltage. After that, plot your observations on the graph and you will find that the AC voltage along with AC voltage, the DC voltage increases up to this much value. Up to this much value, the DC voltage is increasing with the increase of AC. After this much value, DC remains fairly constant, although the AC voltage is varied through a large value. Such characteristics of transistorized regulated power supply is known as the line regulation characteristics, or simply line regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. And this line regulation for transistor regulated power supply is studied for RL is equal to 3000 ohm constant. This is studied for load resistance RL is equal to 3000 ohm constant. After knowing well about how to study line regulation, how to plot the graph for line regulation as it is shown roughly here, let us go to the second part. The second part is about load regulation. To study load regulation, we do one thing. We shall hold input voltage constant. We shall vary load resistance in regular steps, and we shall measure the load current in milliampere and the DC load voltage in volt. So this observation table is needed to study the load regulation of a transistorized regulated power supply. Let us start reading of this. To start reading of this, we shall do one thing. Let us keep the input voltage constant at 220 volt. So as you can see here, you may not be able to see here. Here I have kept input AC voltage is equal to 220 volt. After that, let me start from lower value of the load resistance. Let me take out only 100 ohm and plug in all the remaining keys of the load resistance. So when I take out RL is equal to 100 ohm, you will see that the current is about 44 milliampere. Load current is 44 milliampere and load current is 3.4 volt. Then let us take second value of RL is 200 ohm. Take out the resistance of 200 ohm and close 100 ohm resistance. When we keep RL is equal to 100 ohm, the current is 24 milliampere. The voltage is about 3.6 volt. Now let us make RL 300 ohm by adding 100 ohm to earlier 200 ohms. Here we find that the current is 16 milliampere. The voltage is same, 3.6 volt. Then let us make it 400 ohm by Taking out 400 and closing 100, RL is made 400 ohm. The corresponding current is 12 milliampere. Voltage is the same, that is 3.6 volt. After that, let us select RL is equal to 500 ohm. Take out 500 ohm and close all the remaining keys of the resistance box to get load current is equal to 10 milliampere and load voltage is same 3.6 volt. Then let us go to 1000 ohm. Let us take out 1000 ohm from RL and close 500 to get load current is equal to 6 milliampere and the load voltage is constant 3.6 volt. After that, let us go for one more value, 1500 ohm. When we take out 1500 ohm, the current goes to 4 milliampere, voltage remains same at 3.6 volt. Then let us take RL is equal to 2000 ohm. When we take out RL is equal to 2000 ohm, the current reaches to about 3 milliampere and voltage is same 3.6. And let me go for the last reading, 3000 ohm. RL is taken equal to 3000 ohm. The current is 2 milliampere and the voltage is same 3.6 volt. This is about the study of load regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. What we have done here, we held input AC voltage constant at 220 volt. It is to be held constant for all these observations. Input will be always 220 volt constant. Okay. Then values of load resistances are varied. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, okay, 1000, 1500, 2000, 300, 3000. And what we found? We found that the load current is decreasing continuously with the increase of the load resistance. As we increase the load resistance continuously, the load current is decreasing continuously, and at 3000 ohm RL, load current is minimum simply 2 milliampere. It means that minimum load current is drawn by the power supply from the AC mains, and therefore there is no loading of the power supply on the AC mains power supply. If we compare the increasing values of the load resistance RL with corresponding output DC voltage, we find that just for one value, we got the output DC voltage is equal to 3.4 volt for all remaining values of the RL from about 200 to 3000. The output voltage is remaining fairly constant. It is only 3.6 volt. It means that although the load resistance is varied through 3000 ohm, there is no change in the output DC voltage. It means that this circuit is working as a regulated power supply, a regulated power supply of good quality. After having performed load regulation of a transistorized regulated power supply and noting the observations, we have to go for the graph for load regulation. When we plot graph for load regulation, we shall consider only the output voltage and the load resistance. We are not going to consider the load current. Okay, so what we do, we shall take RL in ohms on x-axis as it is independent variable. Because of variation in this load resistance RL, it may vary the output DC voltage or load voltage, and therefore we shall take load voltage on y-axis. Select proper scale for RL on x-axis and for output DC voltage on y-axis. After that, plot your observations from the table of load regulation, and we find that for almost all values of load resistance, the output DC voltage is remaining constant. For only small value at the beginning, for very small value of the load resistance, the output voltage is shown somewhere here. Otherwise, for all remaining higher values of load resistance, the load current, the load voltage, DC load voltage is remaining fairly constant. This is known as load regulation of transistorized regulated power supply when the input voltage is held 220 volt constant for the whole experiment. This is about the load regulation of transistorized regulated power supply. This is in detail a demonstration of how to perform the experiment transistorized regulated power supply for the two different parts, line regulation and load regulation. Remember, you should remember the circuit diagram for this circuit, because you need to draw the circuit diagram in the examination. After that, you should be able to construct the circuit, and taking all precautions, you have to perform this experiment for line regulation and load regulation. After noting the observations for line regulation in the table made for it, and for load regulation in the respective table, as we have done in the demonstration here. After completing these tables, you have to draw one graph for this table, other graph for this table. The graph you have plotted for this table will be line regulation. For this one will be line regulation, and the graph you have plotted for this will be the load regulation. Okay, and finally you have to write the conclusion or result of this experiment. The transistorized regulated power supply is studied, and it is found that the output voltage of this transistorized regulated power supply remains fairly constant irrespective of changes in the AC mains and the load resistance. This will be the actual result or conclusion of this experiment. Hope this demonstration is simple and you understood. I will send the PDF of the literature needed for this experiment along with this demonstration video. Thank you.